Hey Chris, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com. There is a common misunderstanding that many people have about how business and politics operates in America. When media reports that a certain business or business person donated X number of dollars to a certain political candidate at some point in time, the impression is created that that person or business entity actually supported the policies or beliefs of that particular candidate when that financial support was pledged. The odds of that being true are probably less than 50-50, because business is ultimately very pragmatic. The fact is, it is a common practice of businesses and law firms, for example, to donate, often equally, to both political candidates in a race, because those firms, those businesses, need to transact business, no matter who wins. It's their way of being bipartisan, not political. Because regardless of who wins, they will need to get business done, and may need access, at some point, to at least get their point of view heard without interruption. Don't get me wrong, there are many individuals and businesses who are very partisan in their approach to politics and political donations, but politicians come and go. And the machinations of government that operate behind the scenes stay from administration to administration at all levels of government, regardless of what political party is temporarily in charge. This is just as true on the county level, as it is on the state level, as it is on the federal level. I recall speaking to a large trade organization. I was scheduled to be the closing speaker at the general session just after the buffet breakfast. That group's lobbyist actually spoke at the breakfast before my presentation. It was a short talk, but had a profound impact on the audience and on me. For context, it was early in an election year, just like now. His lobbying firm was renewing their contract for the upcoming year, and like each year before, he gave an elevator speech about the importance of what their firm accomplished for this trade organization and how they protected them. The trade organization was knee-deep in their political action committee, and assigning members to help with those efforts. This lobbyist stood before them and basically said all those efforts, all the funds raised for PACs, all the time they were going to volunteer for their candidate, while noble, would ultimately have little impact on how the system worked for their trade organization. He said congressional and state politicians ultimately make only a fraction of the laws and rules and regulations that go into effect each and every year. He said the real power rests with the infrastructure of the system itself. The individuals that run our government at all management levels in all departments, from administration to administration. Their departments create the majority of the rules and regulations that impact our lives and our businesses. His elevator speech explained that his job was to know and understand who these people are. So when a problem came up, solving that problem was based not just on expertise, but on years of personal relationships. He said the elections mattered maybe 5%, and the behind-the-scenes machinations mattered 95%. It reminded me of the auto mechanic who took 5 minutes and popped a bolt onto the engine of a person's car who happened to be stranded out of town and said, "That will be $50. The customer responded, "$50 for a bolt?" The mechanic said, "It's a dollar for the bolt, but it's $49 to know where the bolt goes." Expertise is always worth a premium. The lobbyist got his firm's contract renewed, as he had done every year for the past decade. But the lessons he shared about understanding where the real power is, was, and always has been within the system was an important eye-opener. He delivered that little breakfast speech in 1996. A lot has changed since then, but a lot has also remained the same. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com, reminding you to follow us on Twitter at ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.
Okay, Robert, thanks for another excellent installment. Well, that wraps up this week's GoldSeek.com radio episode. For two new big guests, be sure to check out next week's show. Until we talk to you again, have a great week.